Finally, we have Doug Daggett, who is running in CD5.
Yes, I'm the endorsed candidate for 5th Congressional District to challenge Keith Ellison. And first of all, I want to congratulate Sharma and Sharna, and I'm looking forward to joining her in the freshman class in January in the United States House of Representatives. What a great, fantastic candidate. Real quickly, this is Nancy LaRoche. She's our chair of 5th Congressional District, and then also David Spalding, one of our vice chairs. Again, my name is Doug Daggett. That's D-A-G-G-E-T-T. Quick background, 25 years in technology sales, most recently working for an American software company for the past over 7 years, where I'm responsible for our business in Europe, Middle East, and Africa. And I want to share with you that it's as a result of my working and living overseas that really ingrained and burned in me and made so clear and opened my eyes to the tremendous blessing that we have to be Americans, to live in the United States, and to see that it's the foundational principles of our country that have made us the strongest, most prosperous, and free and generous nation in the history of the world. And it's only by continuing on with those principles can our country continue to be free and prosperous. The goal of our campaign, what we're doing, is going out to those individuals across the 5th Congressional District who typically have not voted conservative, haven't voted Republican. And I think the tide is turning. The tide is turning. And I think people are seeing that the old ways of doing things, the Democrat ways, they do not work. And that it's not through just a temporary anger at possibly the Democrats, but rather it's because what we offer as Republicans, as conservatives, are true, real solutions for the long term and in the best interests of them and their families. So again, we're looking forward to a great campaign here in holding Keith Ellison accountable. The fact is the things that he stands for are not in the best long-term interests of the people that have even voted for him in the past, and making that very articulate case for the conservative cause. So thank you for the time this morning. Liberty Gala. Looking forward to seeing all of us together at the Liberty Gala on May 8th, Thursday. That's at the St. Paul Historical Center, I believe, fundraiser for the 4th and 5th Congressional Districts. Thanks for all staying late here to give me a chance to talk to not an empty room.
Thank you so much, Doug, and thank you for the lead-in to the final commercial of the day. Liberty Gala is coming up on May 8th. That's a couple weeks. We really, really, really like you to come. It's going to be a great time. Think of it as no speeches. You get to talk to all of the candidates are coming. They're agreeing to put up tables and all that sort of thing. You'll get a chance to put these guys on the grill and really find out what they're made out of. And by guys, I also include the ladies too that are running. So I would urge you to attend. It's a formal affair. It's billed as create a black tie, which means guys, you got to wear a coat and tie. You're gonna look silly without it. I'm wearing a tux. If you have a tux, it's entirely appropriate to do so. It's a major piece of the fundraising we're doing for the 4th Congressional District this cycle. And I wanna thank you very much for such a wonderful turnout today.